All right. Let me know if you guys can hear me. And I will put the stream over just so, or the Slack over. You can hear me? One second. Okay. Should I play? Okay, great. Okay. All right, so I SCP'd it over already, I think. I'm gonna minimize it. And I'm just doing it on my VPS because I don't have a VM set up, so let's take a look. Okay, stripped, dynamically linked, 32-bit. Are you, oh. All right. Enter serial. Good job. Incorrect serial. Nothing too interesting. Incorrect serial. Okay. And let's pop it into here, which I already did, but I haven't taken a look yet. So I'm gonna try to actually do a couple things that are. excuse me, Binary Ninja specific. So let's see if we need to, kind of thing. What's kind of cool is I filed like 7 bugs today and already had 2 of them fixed, but not pushed out yet. Annoying thing is it doesn't show the stack frame unless you're in this view. And then because the way this is GCC, you have to name the args, because they don't actually push them, they just set them. So these are the args out, obviously. What else are they calling? Stringlen. Another annoying thing is you can highlight symbols, it'll highlight other ones, but you can't highlight instructions, so I can't like find all the calls. Alright. Yeah, I'm recording. I'll make it bigger. Sorry about that. Where the fuck is right here? Is this too big? It won't go bigger than this. All right. So let's just walk through it in the debugger. I installed GEF, so let's see how that works out. So Okay. There we go. I actually don't like how it's printing the registers, unfortunately, compared to PETA, but whatever. Okay, anyway. Just making sure we're on the same page. Okay. It's also, like, significantly slower to print the context than PETA is. I'm not exactly sure why. And it doesn't do guest args, which is kind of annoying. Anyway, obviously enter name. And let's just run from here. Oh, oops, I meant continue. And then control C to get backtrace and see the call chain. Get car, so let's go here. And this is called twice, so probably for both, so we'll just say get input. And 4857, that's right here, so yeah, that's exactly what we expect. Cool, let's see what's provided. So, so it looks like it actually allocates its, oops, allocates a buffer of size 20, so that's hard-coded. I don't even see the return. This is a little weird. Right here, okay. Oh, and I can't even move the boxes around. That's also weird. Anyway, what do we return? EAX bar 18. Bar 18 is the alloc buffer, so buff adder. And then this is incremented, so that's obviously some counter. Zero, arc one of the two. So this is obviously all we need to care about. Let's double check. Oh, what the hell? So I didn't even make it to this check. So, does it have to be exactly 16? Oh, okay, sorry. So this is 17 letters. Weird. I'm almost 16. This one is, I think, exactly 17. Jump equal. Alright, so now we're here. All right, now we go to the sub. Oh, let's check. Yeah, it's actually kind of brutal, unfortunately. Hopefully not enough to make me go back to it, but it's actually really hard to use. If only they use the TUI a feature, like use curses and only update when they need to, that'd be a lot better. Okay, anyway, sorry. Continue should hit a breakpoint, and both the name and the serial are provided to it. So let's take a look at that statically. Again, I have to go set this is name serial. And I can't do call graph from, unfortunately, but like we see the calls obviously, so we'll do the same arg thing here. Oh, one cool thing I want to show if we have any globals right here. Okay, so this is just a bunch of bullshit. What I can do is I can click here and hit Y, and I can say that it's a car star. Except it's not a car star. Oh, so N for name, Y for type. So I could say like UN32, right? But that's obviously wrong. Instead, I'll say car. I'm not sure if they expect it in this format. Oh, they took car as the name. So the name accepts special symbols, which is stupid because it's confusing. I meant to hit Y and say car four. There you go. So I think that's basically what we want to do. I wonder if I can do it without size. Nope. Okay, that sucks. Cool. Can I just say, yeah, that's fucked. Can I say string? Nope. And you can't undo the type, unfortunately. Yeah, you can just do void to go back. All right, so this looks like it's taking out 2 bytes at a time. Just kind of skipping ahead 2 bits at a time. XORing. Okay, let's do this. So that's why there's so many locals. I'm gonna actually have to go from the top, unfortunately. So the stack. Okay, so this is. I think this is just canary crap. Holy shit. So the stack check is on this one, compares it to there, so that's just the canary. Oh, and there's no little navigator view, so I have to zoom in and zoom out every time I wanna be able to jump quickly. Alright, so basically read 1 byte from it and move it. So this is some. Oh my god. So can I do this? That's kind of cool. So basically, we're just going 1, 2, 3, whatever, and we're copying 1 byte at a time. Except this is dumb because if I go here, hopefully I could just name it name. I'll just call it, no. And they let you have two names of the same. That's kind of weird. Local name. And I'll try changing the type into. So, what is that? Oh, that just shit. So it looks like I'm gonna have to do this dumb thing. Where they do this. So bear with me. Okay, this extracts just one byte. I kind of do this where there's LEA, I just assume it's some kind of buff. Add two, add four, and we've extracted four so far. We'll just name it zero. One second, I'll show you. One CPU, not very fast. I actually don't know the stats, but it's not very good. But it was still pretty slow on my Mac. All right. Where were we? Oh, they're writing it in into a local. This is just a really crappy way of doing a string copy into this local buff. So string printf for name it zero. XOR 3, 2 plus 2, it's here. Oh fuck me, this is gonna be a lot of shit. To, or do they mean 420 at 2? So we're at 5. No, add literal two, so that's a little weird. I don't know where this variable thing comes in. That means absolutely nothing. Okay, anyway. Target buffer. This I'm gonna skip this for now because I'm more confused than it should be. Sprintf into a local buffer, second arb with this format string, and the third one is EAX, and EAX is just the zero of the first one. Okay, so they read that in and write it here. Then they XOR them, move it, sign extend, no big deal, put that as the second one. But the target buffer, this adding two is just to move 2 bytes forward. Right, that's stupid. It's because they're just turning into a hex string. That's fucking stupid. Okay, and it's processed on the name. So that was stupid of me. Okay, so the first, so encoded string. So first byte, we'll just say first is. Zero. Okay, then they add two to go to the next one. And this second byte is 1 and 3. Okay, then they add 4. EAX. EAX is A and D, which is 2 plus 2. Let's see if it goes forward. Okay, let's go here. Or no, wait, let's go on the first print and just get a handle. So copy address. Oh, not long enough. Stupid idea, okay. So that's 16, 17. Okay, this should be, right here should be sprintf, I believe, good. And then the arguments are, this is what I care about, right here. Oh my god, my color scheme doesn't show this stuff, it blends in. Okay, anyway. That makes sense. Okay, good. We are back on track. Now we have p slash x. Oops, fuck. Right here. There you go, so just so we have $1. Comparison is comparing first one to the serial. Oh, just comparison bit by bit. It's checking 1, 2, 3, 4. That makes sense. But for 5, that shouldn't have been 1, 2. Yeah, okay, 5. So these are literally just comparing it so far, so that we can do it step by step. So what we want to do is we want to get to here. So IB, I can just, D5, breaks. So what we want to do is get to breakpoint 7. And by doing that, let's put in a dummy name. So let's say if my name is Graziano, or let's make it easier. Okay, what I like to do is put spaces when things are getting XORed together. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3. If 1 and 3, I can just put a space there, and that'll make it so that this case of this one when XORed will switch. So now we'd expect A, which is 4, 1. And then second is 1XOR3, which is 6-1. And then 2 plus 2. So this one we probably want, okay. We want something that when added to itself is still in the ASCII range. Right here. So something low like exclamation mark is 3-3. Let's do it here. 3-0 becomes 6-0, which is back tick. Let's do that. Okay, and that should... Oops. 2+2, so again, put a 0. That should yield a back tick, which is 60. All right. Username AA0 space. Enter serial 416160. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. All right, now that's our buffer. Right, as expected, okay. Oh, fuck. G9. What I wanted was this. 4161, continue, finish. 416160, cool. So now we should be able to continue to here. Oh, fuck me. Okay, so that means I failed at some point. If I knew how to do traces better, I could do that. These just copy whatever. Where's the print? We're up here and they go down. Oh, it just returns minus one. It's based on the return value. So no big deal. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, let's double check. So it took the serial copy. Oh, fuck. So this is part of the buffer. So var 21, so that's offset 1. This is really annoying. I'll call this like the check serial. It's at 0. So I really wish or I knew how to... And part of the reason I'm streaming this is so that you can tell me if I'm doing something really stupid or if you have a faster way of this crap. So I'm all ears. Okay, anyway, serial check 0, 1, 2, and 3. I could just put breaks on all these calls. And I guess there should be 2 for each one, so... Oh, shit. Jesus. Finally. Those will do for now. Okay, so run. Name is AA0 space. Serial is 416160. 416160. That's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Number 3. Oh, finish. All right. So DL and AL. Zero. AL 3 4. It's just four. Yeah, it's just four. Okay, so it fails in the first check. Wait, did I check the wrong register? Yes, I did. Where the fuck is DL? Oh, I was going left. It's here, it's to the right. I don't like how that's printed out. Okay. Continue, next comparison. DLAL. 3131, good. 3636. Fuck. Okay. So I think we're 3 bytes that were correct. And I just Oh, it's overwritten. So anyways, we know we passed these 3. I don't know why a fourth would fail. Check, whatever, compare, 3. We have to write a key gen, otherwise I could just like put in any name and just do this manually, so we actually have to correct this. There's no sign zero extend here. What are they comparing it with? Compare it. Oh, so there's a hard-coded value here. So right-click, display as, and then character constant, dash. Okay. I forget how many checks there were, but that's probably it. So 1, 2, 3. That's 2 bytes each for 6. And then the fourth one has to be a dash. So it's 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it looks like this character is supposed to be a dash. 416160 dash. That's weird. So we want to go here. Let's copy the address, but let's go to this comparison and copy that address. No, we can follow it. Okay. Run. AA0 space 41616 dash 41616 dash. Oh, I didn't. Ah, fuck. AA0 space 41616 dash 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Supposed to be 17. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay. Are we getting the same headers allocated? I haven't actually checked that. Anyway, this is what we care about. Piece x. Okay, at 6 now. Continue. That's good. That's good. Yeah, this is too slow. I got lucky there in the number of times I hit enter. Okay, that's good. Now what's p slash c 0x36? It's just a 6. Three one, so that is the 6-1. That's the second 6. So that one's gonna pass. So this is the special comparison. This is the one we were failing on before. Right here, 2D, 2D. Good, good, good. Okay, so we have only the first 4 bytes, correct. But that's fine. Okay, that's progress. Now what was name copy used for? They just copy in 4 bytes and then analyze. Zero, one, two, three. Yep, okay, so it's probably just the exact same thing as before. And that's something you need to do if you want to be fast. Unfortunately, I'm not. Is be able to skip over crap like this. Alright, so read a byte as printf and XOR. This is where we want to name them 2A. This not showing the locals is annoying as fuck. And the weird thing is, it looks like it won't fit all of the names, and the name can be up to 16, so it clearly ignores anything after the first few. All right, so. So the fifth byte, which we know because they're adding EAX to var A1. Var A1 is probably like 5 past. Is it? Oh, interesting. So I'll name these, but I actually haven't seen these ones get filled yet. And obviously, this is going to be 17 or 16 long. I usually put maybe in things when I'm just guessing ahead of time. right. Let's go back down. Cool. So, actually, what I want to see is so we have, oh, I should call these 0, 0, 1, 2. Anyway, so we know 3 is checked. 4, I just want to get the highlighting to see where it's done. No, it doesn't do it. Fuck. I had 4 highlighted in the other view, but it's not working. Okay, anyway. So this is 4 and 5. Sorry, so where's the XR? Six. Oh. Oh no, this one's special. So this one is EAX and it's stored into 6. It might not even check those two, who knows? Okay, anyway, the one stored in 6 is EAX, and it comes from EAX, EDX, EDX, and ECX, and ECX. So it's 4 plus 5 XOR 6. All right. Okay, now they go 2 past. Oh, and also I'm being inconsistent here because these are actually 2 bytes at a time. Right, so I'll call it like that. That's why. I hope. So, this SE check. So this is 41616 dash. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay. So that's perfect. So we only want the first nibble of that, and then you want to OR in, or no. Yeah, so F0 and then 5 is just that. Sorry for the confusion. This is the first set of checks, second set of checks. Okay, 6, XOR, blah, blah, blah. So that's what we get here. That was from this. So, EAX. EAX here for 8 is. Four XOR 5. That's these two. Plus EDX ECX, which is 7 and 4. And let's, and then it's 6 plus 2, which is 8. Cool. All right, 6 plus 2 is 4, and we're storing in A. A comes from. 7 XOR. So EDX. EDX is 6 plus 8. No, 6 plus 6. 6 plus 6. So I should have gone in the opposite order. 6 plus 6 into EDX. XORed with 7. Yeah, so I'll switch the order so if I have to double check, I don't confuse myself. Cool. And finally, first comparison is 6. And they're going 6 into it and just comparing it. Cool. Second, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9, 9, 10, 10. Good. 11. See, again, the 11th is special. So this one is AND 0, XF 0. 11 is 2D. Boom. Dash. And then a last check. So I think we're just about done. EAX is, let's go from, ooh, this is, so let's just name this bad boy. Oh, but it was actually saved already from here. Okay, so EAX at 8, call it 8 for now, or sorry, N8, and then 9. This is, oh, I'm stupid again. This is just the copying in. That's fine. Good. That makes our life easier. All right. So that's easy. So 12 is 8 XO0X A6. Okay, EAX, now this is another slightly more convoluted one, so it looks like it's, what the fuck is this? So this one is 9 plus 11, XORed with 10. And then added to 8. To make sure about the 8, so N8 is used twice. Okay. That's for this one. Now this one, which is what we finally care for. This is the end of the line, I think. Okay. EAX. EAX is something. XO0X46. It's EAX and EDX, which is 10 and 11, added. Yeah, so 10, 11, XOR. Okay, now compare 12, compare 13, 14, 15, 16. That's it. So it doesn't care about the 17th one. Okay, so now let's write some code. I'm going to put this on my other monitor. okay. Okay. Vim need. Right. So, this is should be rather simple. Okay. Okay, now we'll pad it to the minimum length, which is looks like it's 12. We can just put a null bytes in there. So if len name is under 12, name plus equals name or name equals name plus a null byte times 12 minus 11 of name. Okay, now, I won't even do a loop, I'll just do this really ugly. So I'll go serial equals nothing. Let's make it a byte string. Okay. Zero. Serial plus equals name at zero. Except I think the proper way to do it is this will probably work. So that actually shed 2 bytes. And of course, this won't work because I have to do ord. So let's say def I'm not sure if I should just do the ord manually, but we'll do it. Okay. These are numbers, which means this has to be ord. Okay, so this one I'll have to truncate off the first byte. Well, I can say 4 or 5. Okay, so ord of name 2 plus ord name 2 and then we'll just say the first byte of that. The first nibble, rather, but first character of that plus like that. And before I get ahead of myself, let's validate that the first couple characters will work. All right. So let's do AA0, AA0 space. So this is a bad choice. 41616 dash. So it looks like we're doing okay so far. Oops, matches what we have here so far. All right, let's continue. I hate fucking working in this putty thing because the fucking terminal goes off every 2 seconds. FYI. 6-7. Let's do this. So it's 4. XOR 5 plus seven. Seven. That looks good. Be more like this one. XOR ord name 7. And then cut off the first one and add a dash. Okay. Oh. Twelve, 13. That one is the hard-coded one, so it's like this. Oh, I just realized something when I was that back here, it's checking at 16, so it is actually checking the 17th one. That's this one. It doesn't actually care about the front half of it, but it shouldn't matter. So we're just doing one character more than we need to. Added. Hate. Should be good. So it might fail just because of the length. Let's try. Cool. And let's try with something cooler. All right. Wish me luck. 1, 2, 3, 0. C dash 7, 8, 0, 8. B dash D 4, 0, 0, 4, 6. So that's 5, 5, 5. Oh wait. So I don't need that 6 at the end. Fuck. Okay. We'll have to debug this. I'm trying to think of the easiest way to figure out which one it failed on. So what we can do, obviously there's a couple checkpoints after each of these. So I'm gonna go here, foreground, and quit out of the debugger, if it'll work. What did I say? It's 4, 7, I'd put 7, 7. Oh, I put S. Well, I still have a mistake, so that sucks. Let's see. You're right, I'll try it, but I did it on purpose because I think it's one byte more than we need. It's three groups of five plus two dashes. Let me try it again. I think it's too long. 4, 7, 0, 8. C dash 7, 8, 0, 0, 0, 8, B dash D 4, 0, 0, 4, 6. Yeah, I think it's because it's too long. Anyways, we'll see quickly. For some reason, the copy and paste isn't working very reliably. So that's right here. Right here, 8, 7. So that's good. We've made the first one. The first four are correct. Let's go here. Copy address. Incorrect serial. So it's in the second blob. So let's check these ones. And I will bring this back in to double check. So 4. So these are good. To check 6. EAX comes from EDX. EDX is CX is 5. 5 plus 6, XOR 4. Whoa. Okay, we're wrong on the first one. Five plus six. Wow, okay, that was easy. Should I check the rest? I don't think I'm gonna. So that was 4, 6, 7. So that's 4 XOR 4708C dash A 608B dash D 404. Okay, well, we can run that again. So foreground, run. Let's double check if I actually entered it correctly. 4708C. Wait. Right here. A6, EB, D4. Okay. Oh, I do. So it still failed in the second group, probably, unless I somehow started failing on the first. So let's put another breakpoint here. So it should hit breakpoint 3 and then fail before 2. Breakpoint 3 fails. Okay, let's just look a little bit more into here. Okay, so printf EAX. EAX, which is 4 XORed with 5 and 6. Okay, that's correct. Here, this one, it's EX and EDX. EDX and ECX at 7 and 4 XORed, and EAX and EDX. EAX, 4 and 5. So that looks okay. So this one is 10, so I don't need this anymore. Oh yeah, I do. Okay, so it's 7 and EDX, which is 6 and 6. That looks correct. What the fuck? Alright, so I'm going to have to do the annoying compares here. So, again, I'm going to drop out and come back in. And set some breakpoints. I wish there was a nice way to just do a whole bunch of breakpoints. Especially when this copy and paste doesn't work. Fuck. Didn't stop for me. Okay, it's recorded anyway, so I can put it up. I didn't know there was more than two people watching, to be honest. Maybe I would have swore a bit less. I can just walk from there. Okay. Oops. Okay, that one's good. The second one's wrong. Okay, so 6-5 is E or something. And it is it's expecting a 0. Or no, I'm a 0. So, in the comparison, EA comes from the copy. Check is, so it's actually supposed to be 6-5. I think that's E, small e. And it's actually 0. Okay, let's run it again and see which comparisons worked. Ah, fuck. Alright, so 3-6, PSRC0 is 3-6, is 6. That means I accidentally skipped one. Okay, so that's good. So that's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it's 8 that's wrong. Let's double check. EAX, so EAX, EDX, EAX is 1 byte XOR 4 and 5 plus XOR 4 and 7. What the hell? It's 7 plus 4, not 7 XOR 4. So we do know the E was correct, which means the 0 must have been. So we're going to go back to check the last part again. So I think we're probably, hopefully, past the second block. Which means this is the second block of compares. I'm really hoping we'll get to this address. Okay, good. So we're on the third block now. Let's just do a better analysis because I did that lazily. I don't need to. What I'm doing is, Chad, I'm doing just this to slice off the first bit. to get the because it's actually like each byte is going to two characters. I'm just taking the first character. But thank you. All right. So now we got these left. So 12 comes from A6 with 8. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I didn't check that those indices are correct. It is. Okay, so that's fine. So 8 is A6 XOR 8. It looks good. Next one, EAX is. Oh, see, I got it wrong. It's ANDed. So EAX is 8. So this should be a logical AND. And again, because I'm lazy, I'm just going to assume that that's the only mistake I made. Oh, it didn't change. It didn't change it. D4. That's weird, I didn't change it, but that means that I know I have to look more. Okay, so 14. EAX, XOR, make sure I have to check these instructions. XOR 46 with 10 and 11. Wow, that one's easy. That one, how can that not be right? Okay, I have to go to the slower comparison. This copying thing is driving me insane. Okay. Doesn't even make it that far. Fuck. So it makes it here, but fails the first one. So it should 3, 6, 4 with 6, 1, which is A versus D. So it's supposed to be a D6, which means that this one's wrong. How did it? I swear it passed it before, though. Didn't it? Or wait. Wait, it must be this one. A6. Okay, cool. So it's not that one. It is this one. 12, EAX, A6, 8, but that doesn't make sense to me. That one's like the easiest one. So, oh, do you know why? Fuck! I bet you it's because they put a new line there and we have a null byte there. Because my name is 8 characters long. So let's try not changing anything and running it with a longer name. So they do warn you about the character length. But this one has to be exact, which we are. So we know it's not because of Graziano, Graziano, they're like counting an extra character. Okay, so back to slow mode. So it's first comparison. Again. Interesting. Let's try the same program with my shorter name and this shorter ser or different serial. Oh, God damn it! I was entering the extra character. Let's try this. Okay, at least I'm hitting the breakpoint. I'm not absolutely crazy. Okay, so this is on 885F. So this is comparing the D. Oh, interesting. It's off by one. Obviously, E. So it expects this one to be E. And okay, this is G R A Z I A N. Or no, it's not like that. Never mind. It's D just after this. So it's 8. Right. So the original buffer at 8. So buffer at 8 should be G. So car board of G XOR 0x46. What? Oh, I don't want the car. So it's 0 1. 01, so it might be my string formatting. That seems okay. Oh my God! You see that? I still think that's wrong because I don't think it'll work. Because that's not what it's expecting. It's expecting. Is it A6? Oh, it is A6. Seven. Oh my God. So one of them is 4-6 and one of them is A6. This one's A6, this one's 4-6. And this should be an 8. This is embarrassing. Sorry, guys. Yes, there's the E we expect. I'm really hoping this will work. Oh, fucking finally. Where's Slack? I can't copy. Do I have to submit it on your stupid site? What's the URL? Okay. So, this should work because it's a long user. I'm not sure if a short user would work properly. Uh-oh. Extra character. Good job. Did I get it? Oh, sorry, I was entering it here. Did I get it? I don't know if that's a flag. Oh. Did it time out? Because I can't get the prompt anymore. Okay, good. Cool. So that was fun. I didn't use too many binary ninja stuff, but I think I demonstrated very well how annoying it can be with things like no buffers, right? I had to like name these all manually. That sucked. Cool. All right. I'm gonna turn it off then. You should. No, not every second, every minute or something. I did. But no, it said it would do every 2 minutes, whatever. We're good. See you guys.